Oneka.
I always dreamt of a house far away from where I grew up. A place I saw in a newspaper. My mother used to say that a family tie is like a tree. It can bend, but it cannot break. And although I did not understand the meaning of it at the time, I laid in wait, watching the wind trying to prove my mother wrong. The winds can be very strong, and I prayed she was right. Grandmother and I used to go to the market once a week. I was always in a hurry. I wanted to spend as much time in the city as possible. It was different from my life in the village. I would find things on the ground, garbage for them, but treasures for me. I had a collection beside my bed. Those items took me to places I have never seen. But one day, on the way to the city, rebels crossed our path. Until then, I had never heard the sound of a gunshot. The rebels told me that tears are for the weak. I did cry, many times. And I got beaten for it. I tried to soothe the pain, and for that, they made me lie down on the ground. Then they beat me again. I never cried again. After 1 year with the rebels, I knew that if I stayed, I would be lost forever. I would be like the others. Ruthless, fearless, and I would feel nothing. I decided to escape. I waited till it was dark. I ran all night, hiding at first light. I don't know how many nights I spent in the bush till I made it home. Maybe a week, maybe longer. I could not get rid of my gun. It was my mother, my friend. It was my savior. Without it, I felt empty.
McKenna!
My parents didn't even recognize me. They had hope that I didn't change to someone they had to fear. But I had become someone else. I was very rough. I was kicking my sister. They made me furious. And sometimes, I wanted to kill them. My parents tried their best, but they were scared of me. I always dreamt of a place far away from where I grew up. I liked our village. It was a simple life. In the morning, I helped my mother sweep and clean the hut. My father was in the fields with the herds. I would play ball and hide and seek with my friends. But I knew I didn't want to live the same life like my parents. I wanted to live in the city, learn to read and write. In my dreams, I lived in a different place. But the rebels took away my dreams. I'm scared not to sleep.
Oneka.
Killing happened every day, and I became used to it. When you see something over and over again, it doesn't affect you anymore. It came to the point where I would come across a dead body, and I would just jump over it and continue walking. They made me drink and eat. They sliced and fried them first. They said I had to do this to conquer my fear. Human blood was the first thing I would have in the morning. It was my hot chocolate.
No, no.
Oneka. Oneka.
Oneka. Oneka. Oneka.
I wake up at night from the sound of crying babies. I was there. I helped them when we captured women and babies. They separated the babies from their mothers. Then, they loaded their guns and shot their mothers. They fired on Otto. Then they killed their babies. They swung them by their legs and smashed them against the tree. I did not want to die. I feared the loneliness of death.
Stop! Where are you going?
6 months after I fled the rebels, early one morning, rebels from another group attacked our village. They needed more children to fight for them. The spirits of people I killed haunt me. A woman I killed would come to me asking, why? Most times I dream, I have a gun. I'm killing. I'm firing. Cutting. Dismembering. I feel afraid, thinking that perhaps these things will happen again. When I killed for the first time, I was changed forever. I became one of them, one of the rebels. I saw no escape. I thought maybe everything was just a bad nightmare, and I was still that boy who loves to chase the chickens and collect things from the city streets and build my own world. The rebels told me by killing my parents, it would be a sign of courage.
You're going to be a man now, huh?
I want you to shoot them, huh?
Finish them!
My mother begged me to do what I had to do to save my life.
Shoot them!
I was not afraid to die anymore.
Come on! Shoot them!
If you do not shoot them, your sister will take your life. Huh?
It was my only escape to never wake up.
Finish them! Kill them! Shoot them!
It meant freedom.
Shoot them!
It's okay. It's okay.
You are my new soldier. You're going to be my wife.
I want you to kill him.
Forgive me.
Shoot them. Shoot him. Come on. Come on. No.
Yeah.
coldness started creeping into my body, and the trembling started. I looked at my body from the outside. I knew I would die. Death was trying to take my soul. My soul was already outside of my body. Suddenly, I couldn't hear anything. For the first time, I felt free. I understand now what my mother meant. A family tie can never break, just bend like a tree. I still have the nightmares, the flashbacks, the fear, the guilt. It's part of my life now. But sometimes I wish I would be dead.
Oneka, the world is a journey, but the world to come is the home. For now, you on your journey.